If there's a layer on a panel that you'd like to animate, the first thing you need to do is enable its animation properties. And you do this by clicking on the little gray standing man here, and he'll turn into a little yellow running man. So this lets you know that you can now animate all the elements on this layer. The next thing you need to do is select the transform tool from the motion toolbar. And right away, the motion controls appear. Then what you should do is add a keyframe. So I'm going to do this by clicking on the Add Keyframe button in the Tool Properties panel for the Transform tool. Unlike when adding keyframes to the camera, which appear along this row in the timeline view, element keyframes do not appear in the timeline view. Then what you can do is take the playhead in the timeline view and drag it across to a different frame, and then click on the Keyframe button again, or if you make a motion, a keyframe will automatically be created. So I'm going to pull along this red arrow here to constrain the movement along the horizontal axis until Terry is completely out of the camera frame. And now if I scroll back and forth, you can see that he moves until he's out of the camera frame. Other indicators that you'll see of the first frame and last frame are these two yellow points here with the motion path indicated in between. You can also use these two icons here to jump back and forth between the two keyframes. And that also lets you know that you're for sure on a keyframe and not somewhere in between, such as when you move the playhead. And this makes it easier for you to delete a keyframe because you know for sure you're on a keyframe, as well as reset the motion on a keyframe, which you can also do. And that brings you back to the start position.